Hey man, it's your boy Live out here. Shouts out to all my subscribers. Blaze Nation, man. Listen, man, I got that big Shaquille O'Neal paint beast build, man. Yes, sir, Shaquille O'Neal. Now, this is the most dominant paint beast you'll find on the net. I'm telling you, search YouTube all day, you ain't gonna find this build. Make sure y'all drop a like on this video. We trying to get 60 likes. Y'all already know what time it is. That's the goal. 60 likes. Where my like squad at, man? If you trying to win these 99 overall shoes that 2K sent to me, just hit me up on Instagram, Blazes Live, and send me a DM, bro. We gonna get you these shirts so you can get in the giveaway for these shoes, bro. Sorry, I'm a little choked up. Had a long morning. But anyway, let's get right into this build. I've been sitting here for like 4 hours because I'm making a big. I'm playing 3v3 Prime right now. I'm going crazy. But sometimes we don't have a center. But we definitely got a big flourish of guards. So I'm making a build right now. And I wanted to make Shaq. I felt like Shaq is the most dominant build in the game. Now, a lot of y'all probably going to want guard builds. I got them guard builds on the way. But for all my centers, man, drop a like right now if you're trying to make Shaq, bro. Drop a like. Drop a comment right now, man. This build is going to be outrageous, all right? So the pot chart I'm going with for this build is going to be defensive rebounding and finishing, all right? That's Shaq. Shaq has defense, and he has finishing. So you're going to go equally strong on both of those, and you're going to have a little bit of shooting, a little bit of playmaking, but we already know that means absolutely no shooting, no playmaking, all right? So click that pie right there, and you want to go with the most balanced pot chart, I think, to make Shaq. Because Shaq was evenly strength, vertical, and agility, in my opinion. So you definitely want to go with the last pie chart for this Shaq build, man. Definitely drop a like so we can get up on this YouTube recommendation, man. 60 likes is the goal. Let's go, man. Boom. So here we have it, man. Get y'all screenshots out. This is the Shaq set your potential. You want to be the most dominant paint beast? Make sure you copy this. Make sure you drop a like on the video. Your close shot's going to be 88. Your driving layup is going to be 69. Your driving dunk's going to be 75. The most important stat in this will be the standing dunk, which is maxed out at 95, bro. You know when you catch the ball, you just, like Shaq do? Yeah, big 95. Your post hooks is at 80. Your mid-range, you don't need that because we not shooting nothing, bro. We don't need no threes, all right? So all that's on low. Put your joint on 62 for your free throws so you're not shooting like Shaq. You want to be dominant like him, but you don't want to shoot free throws like him in them pro-am games, you know what I'm saying? In them rec games. So make sure you put your free throw at 62. Leave your post hook at 43, all right? Your pass accuracy is 42. Your ball handling is 38. Your post moves is 69. Now, this is where the bread and butter comes from, man. Your 88 interior defense. Leave your perimeter defense on 0. Your lateral quickness will be 54. Your steals is 62. You're going to max out your block at 88. Max out your offensive rebound at 87. And max out your defensive rebounding at 87, man. This is straight Shaq right here. 22 finishing badges and 25 defensive and rebounding badges. All right? You're only getting one for shooting, one for playmaking, but we already know paint beast don't need that. You heard me. Now we're gonna get into the build. I felt like Shaq is gonna be defined. You can put Burley, you can put Built. All right, I think Built will be the most safest bet for Shaquille O'Neal, you know what I'm saying? Shaquille's a god, bro. Don't get it twisted. Shaq was a god, and when you talk about the best big men in the game, Shaquille O'Neal is definitely in that top five conversations, man. I don't care who you are, if you are a mouse or a man, you're going to say Shaq. So we're going with the Built. Built, all right? And your height is going to be 7'2", okay? You're going to get +3 interior defense, which is huge, very huge. And you get +1 on block. Once you go to 7'3", you start taking too many big hits. All right, so stay away from that 7'3", stay at 7'2", and put your weight, put your weight up to 170, 277 pounds. I think it's the perfect weight, All right. This weight right here should definitely give you the Shaq type look, Shaq type size, Shaq type strength, and give you the agility you need to be a god in that paint. All right. This is what my build is going to look like. I'm going with the 95.3 wingspan. I'm not going with the max wingspan. I feel like the max wingspan is overrated. Everybody always go with max. So just because everybody's going with that wave, I'm going with the 95.3. I think this is going to give you the perfect Shaq type build, man. All right. So let's continue that out. Now, this is where we at, man. We at the takeover screen. Now, you can go with the rim protector takeover, or you can go with the glass cleaner takeover. Now, I'm going to break down what the rim protector takeover is going to help you with. All right. If you're playing 1v1 on the 1v1 court, or you're playing, I would say threes or twos in a park, you know, stuff that don't really matter, then I will go with that rim protector takeover, man. You know what I'm saying? But if you're playing in comp, 3v3 pro-am, rec pro-am, like, you know what I'm saying, comp, you definitely want to go with that glass cleaner takeover. It's going to show you where all the rebounds is, where all the rebounds go. It's going to be an animation on your screen that show you, okay, the ball's going right here when it bounces off the rim. OP, all right? So I'm going with the glass cleaner takeover. My build is complete. And as you can see, paint beast Shaquille O'Neal, man. Hassan Whiteside, Rudy Gobert. But listen, man, this is Shaq. This is the Shaq build right here, bro. This is the Shaq build right here, bro. Now, anybody that wants this build, send them to this video. I got Shaq for y'all, man. Make sure y'all drop a like right now. We trying to get 60 likes on this video, bro. I'm so passionate. This is my big this year, bro. Unless I find a glass cleaner lock build that can give me the same presence like this build right here, I'm going with this for my big this year, man. Alright, so let's test this build out. I want to show y'all and talk about the badges a little bit, because just because you make this build, you already know on 2K this year is about your badges, man. It's about the badges. So the first pack of badges we're going to talk about is the finishing badges. All right, so take a look at the way I got these badges set up. Now, obviously, you can move these badges around when you max them out, but for the most part, this is what I think is best for starting out playing 3v3 pro-am and straight comp games and rec and stuff like that, man. Back down Punisher is the first badge I want to talk to y'all about, man. Allows players to have more success than normal when backing down the defender in the paint. This back down Punisher is godly. And I don't even need to explain contact finisher. You guys already know that this badge is absolutely necessary if you call yourself Shaq, if you call yourself a paint beast. There's no way you can't have this badge on Hall of Fame, bro. Now, should you get this badge first on Hall of Fame, I wouldn't say you're wrong for doing it, all right? Relentless Finisher is absolutely necessary. It's a great badge. I use this on my scoring machine this year. This badge is OP. Improves players' ability to take a lot of contact by reducing the energy lost when attacking the rim for contact shots, man. Relentless Finisher is necessary if you're trying to be Shaq, all right? Now, let's talk about Lob City Finisher. Now, a lot of people might feel like this badge is a little bit unnecessary considering it's on Hall of Fame, but I'm telling you, when the lobs go, they go. When you catch them, they go down, bro. If you catch them at a high rate, it's easy points. And as you know, lobs give you the most rep in PvP pro-am and rec everywhere. Lobs just give crazy rep. So why not have this badge on Hall of Fame, man? And just to break down the badge, so you improve the player ability to successfully finish an alley-oop, layup, or dunk. Not just a dunk, a layup too. The shot must be taken before the receiver lands. All right, and we going with the Slithery Finisher Hall of Fame. This badge is godly. Just to break it down, it increases the player's ability to slide through traffic and avoid contact during gathers and finishes at the rim, man. All right, the Slithery Finisher is godly. Make sure you had this on there. Now, I was left with 2 points, and I was thinking maybe fancy footwork, or even this giant slayer, even though I'm a giant, like, I don't know what to pick. So I just went with putback boss. I feel like when you're playing tools, gonna be a lot of bricks being shot by your guard. And why not have putback boss? You feel me? Enables putback dunks and boosts the shots attributes of a player that attempts a putback layup or dunk right after getting an offensive rebound, man. I feel like the putback boss is a godly badge, man. And this is the way I'm going with the finishing badges for Shaq. Like I said earlier in the beginning, you can move these badges around however you want. But for the most part, man, this is the way it should be set up for Shaq, man. So we gonna get right into this one shooting badge, bro. Now, if you only get one shooting badge, right, it's like, what do we go with? We only get one. We never ever shooting, right? I felt like the best thing to go with is clutch shooter, bro, because you never know when you in a 19-19 situation or you in a point game situation, they throw you the ball under the basket, maybe this bags boosts your chances of winning a clutch game, right? You only get one, why not go with the one that says clutch, man? So that's what I'm picking for clutch shooter. And just to break it down, it says shot attempts that occurred during the final moments of the fourth quarter or in any overtime period receives a large boost. Now, you rec players, a lot of y'all that play rec fourth quarter overtime games, come on, don't tell me this badge is not godly, bro. Like, come on, man. That's the badge I'm going with if you only get one shooting badge. All right, now playmaking, it's a little, I feel like all the badges for big man and playmaking is broke, bro. Break starters broke, bailout broke, unpluckables broke. All right, the badge that probably give you the most love or help would probably be either Needle Threadler or Postspin Technician, and I was going with Postspin Technician. All right, this badge right here, attempting to do post spins or drives result in more effective moves and less of a chance to be stripped, man. If you got it on lease bronze, I feel like it helps you from getting stripped under the basket when you about to set up to do them post moves. You heard me. Shaq is a GOAT. He does post moves. I'm going with Post Spin Technician. Now here we are, the bread and butter, man. Make sure you pay attention to how I set up these defensive badges. So here we are with these Shaq defensive badges, man. I call these Shaq defensive badges because, as you guys know, Shaq was very dominant in the paint. He was a straight god on defense. Most guys didn't even want to drive on him, all right? I want this box on Hall of Fame. This badge right here is absolutely necessary. Strengthens the player's ability to effectively box out opponents in anticipation of a rebound. So when you got that rebound takeover with this badge on Hall of Fame, it pretty much gives you a 98% chance to get the board, unless you just don't know what you're doing. All right, and this video is tough because this is going to be brutally honest. Now, I'll probably get eat up for this because a lot of guys going to be like, man, why isn't all these badges Hall of Fame? Why are you putting them gold? I feel like when you spread it out a little bit, put them gold, your player has a little bit more versatile. Like, you can do a lot more. All right, so I'm going with the brick wall on gold. As you guys know, the brick wall is godly. This badge makes it tougher for defense to get through or avoid screens. Players hit by contact from a brick wall will lose more energy than normal. All right, so obviously Hall of Fame sounds amazing, but the reason why I don't put this on Hall of Fame because you get that park badge. And if you guys pay attention to Mike Wang, he's pretty much saying the park badge with brick wall on gold is pretty much the max you can get it. You don't get a super boost. If you put it on Hall of Fame, it's pretty much like the park badge not working. So why not save that point and stretch your player's ability to do different things? So that's why I went with the gold brick wall, all right? Defensive leader is an absolutely godly badge, bro. Lift the defensive abilities of teammates when on the court. Also, at Hall of Fame level, see the potential shot percentages of opposing players. Now, this badge technically should be on Hall of Fame just for that last thing that it said, how it showed you the percentages of people that shooting on the other team. But I felt like Worm was a decent badge to have, and just putting this on goal is up to you. Put it on Hall of Fame, take away Worm, however you feel, man. I will go with this because, like I said, I'm going for trying to let my guy be able to do the very most it can possibly do. No peak. All right. The Intimidator. Offensive players have less success shooting when contested by players with this badge. Also boost the shot defense ratings when tightly guarding an opponent. All right. So this Intimidator badge is godly. People say it's better on Hall of Fame. A lot of people have been telling me it's godly on gold, bro. It makes people miss. Like, Hall of Fame don't really make a big difference, but when you lose that point, it makes a big difference, right? So I put it on gold, save that point. Now, rebound chaser, you already know this, gotta be Hall of Fame. Increases a player's ability to track down rebounds some farther distances than normal. It has to be Hall of Fame. Do not forget to put this badge on Hall of Fame. Rim protector, come on, man. Improves player's ability to block shots. Unlock special block animations and give a boost to the takeover beater for the blocker and blockers, teammates following a block. Come on, man. Hall of Fame, bro. And obviously, Tyler's defenders, godly. You need this badge on at least gold. Allows defenders to play defense more aggressively without losing energy at the same rate as a normal player. So they're pretty much telling you a whole Martian out there when you're playing defense, bro. All right? So this is the defensive badges I went with. A lot of people will go with more Hall of Fame badges, but I feel like, man, let's stretch our reach, bro. Let's be able to do a little bit more than just the average. Alright, this is my Shaq build. I hope y'all appreciate this build. It took me a while to put it together. It's gotta be the best demigod build in the paint, bruh. Y'all let me know. This is gonna be the center. Hope y'all catch me out there with this build. Hope y'all see me all summer with this build if I'm not on my storm machine, bruh. I'm going crazy. Make sure y'all drop a like. Hit that sub button, man. We trying to get 60 likes on this video. It's your boy Live and I'm gone.